guys, welcome back to my channel. So today's video is going to be jam-packed with some fun things. As you can tell by the title, apartment hunting is a huge part of it. That has been requested on my channel for so long, pretty much ever since we've been in New York. So I'm really excited to unpack that and really talk about apartment hunting here because I did vlog our process, which is what I've been up to the past couple weeks. But first and foremost, I haven't seen you guys since Patrick and I went on our honeymoon. We kind of spur of the moment decided to go on our honeymoon. And I say spur of the moment because we had been planning and kind of putting it off for like since September when we got married. We kept trying to think of places to go and we were trying to make sure the weather was right. And we were kind of like, you know what? No, let's go to Hawaii. It's one of Patrick's favorite places in the entire world. And I had been there once back in high school. So we decided to go to Hawaii and it was like the best decision we ever made. It was so fun.
Look at that service.
I'm really glad I pulled out my camera and got some of those clips to make a cute little montage. It'll be fun to look back on, but also share with you guys since you have been so involved in our wedding journey on YouTube. So that was really fun. We loved Hawaii. I mean, it was seriously all we needed for our honeymoon. Normally when we go on these big trips for videos, we have this really long itinerary planned and like our days are pretty packed full. So it was nice to just spend time with each other, relax on the beach. Patrick got to go surfing. We did a few activities here and there and it was just amazing. But now let's get into the apartment hunting section because that's kind of what we've been busy with. Right after the honeymoon, we kind of went into like adulting mode. We just had like everything we had to do between health insurance, taxes, and now finding an apartment pretty last minute. Yeah, long story short, we kind of weren't set in stone on moving this year. I know I had talked about it in my New Year's video, and we were kind of just gonna like casually see what was out there. And then, you know, we just kind of pulled the trigger on it because there are a lot of things, which I will get into maybe in a different video, of things we didn't really love about this apartment and thinking about our future, maybe starting a family. We could not do that here for many reasons. So we were like, yes, let's look for an apartment. So when we notified our landlord of this place, because we've been in this place for 3 years, he was like, okay, yeah, you have to be out in 2 weeks. That's when your lease is up. And we thought our lease was a different date and it was just this whole fiasco. So I was like, crap, I really gotta focus on finding a new apartment, a new place to live, you know, that whole thing. So Patrick and I have been in New York for 5 years and we've been in two apartments, both in Brooklyn, and we are currently looking for a place in Brooklyn as well. So I will not be doing any apartment hunting in Manhattan. I do not know what it's like. It's probably similar, but different things on the market. But we've always lived in Brooklyn. We really like it. So I know a lot of you guys have been requesting this video. Either you want to move to New York, you already live in New York and are just want to know my experience, or you're just curious. So either way, I hope this helps you, but this is all going to be from a Brooklyn apartment hunting experience. So our first apartment was in Dumbo, Brooklyn, and it was a nicer, newer building. It had all updated appliances. It was on the smaller side, so far the smallest place we've ever looked slash lived in, which is normal. New York has pretty small apartments for what you get, and you will be shocked for how much people pay for very small places. But we loved that place. We lived there for 2 years. We left for two reasons. We left because the neighborhood changed quite a bit, and we left because our rent was increasing quite a bit. And that is pretty much due into part of how much Dumbo has changed. I made a Dumbo New York City guide, although it's not entirely useless, but the neighborhood has changed so much. There are so many new restaurants, shops, parks that have built up there, that it's become a huge tourist attraction in New York, in Brooklyn. A lot of people go there to take photos. It's beautiful. I understand why. I shot a lot of my beginning New York videos there. It's beautiful, but it became really, really crowded, and Patrick and I knew we wanted to kind of move into a different part of Brooklyn to kind of get away from that. We wanted the more neighborhood kind of feel. So our place that we are currently in, we have been here for 3 years, and we are located in Fort Greene, Brooklyn. We love this neighborhood. It is amazing. We live in a pre-war style building. So like I said, with our Dumbo place, it was very updated. We had all new appliances. We had people that were ready to fix anything if anything was broken, and you definitely pay for that. So this, we knew that we wanted to go for something a little bit more like older New York. There's a lot of cool features in this apartment that you probably have seen throughout vlogs and my apartment tour, that we love. The crown molding, the way the apartment's set up. Now everything's a very open concept setup. That's how they're just building them here. Whereas this is very, there's lots of hallways, little rooms, just details with doorways and archways. It's a beautiful, beautiful building. Or apartment, I should say. And we love it, but like I said, there are a few things that we knew we needed to move out of, and I will get into that in a different video, just to save the length of this video, because I want to get into us actually searching. So when it came to finding a new place, I told the broker that we wanted to stay in either Fort Greene, Clinton Hill, maybe even go to Brooklyn Heights, Cobble Hill, those type of areas. If you're familiar with Brooklyn, you'll know what I'm talking about. If not, they're very easy to look up on a map where that is in Brooklyn. It's really easy to get into Manhattan this way. I mean, it's pretty easy anywhere you go, but we just didn't want to go more by like Williamsburg and Greenpoint. No particular reason, we just like this area over here. A lot of our friends live over here, and we wanted to see what was available. So I have my notes of all the apartments we saw. We saw three apartments, and I know that that might seem like not a lot, but both our Dumbo and this place we found pretty quick. This place, in fact, we walked in and said yes. We didn't even look at anything else. So we were pretty quick when it comes to this stuff, but I wanted to make sure I got at least three to know what we really wanted. The first apartment we looked at two units in this building. It is a newer, nicer building, definitely more updated. We are a little hesitant to look at this one because we weren't sure if we wanted to move into a building like this, which I know seems crazy because everything's so new and nice, but we really liked the charm of this place and the charm of having like an older New York apartment, and we really aren't the type of people that need all the extra frills, but there were a lot of things that were appealing about this place that I will get into a second. But let's go ahead and talk about the first unit that we walked into. It is a one bedroom, one and a half bath plus home office slash nursery. So it's not a full two bedroom because that one bit is a little bit more of an open concept. A little bit, it is an open concept. And the bathroom was an ensuite bathroom, so it was attached to the master bedroom. And then the half bath was more by that home office. It has in-unit laundry and dishwasher. And I don't know if I mentioned it, but it has a kitchen island, which makes sense for the next unit that I'm about to talk about. And the price on that is $4,300 a month. So we liked that one. The next one was on a different floor, and it was $4,100 a month, so $200 cheaper. And the reason for that, it was the same overall, one bedroom, one and a half bath, plus home office slash nursery. The difference is there's no island and no ensuite bathroom. So it had the laundry, it had the dishwasher, literally everything. So to us already, we liked that one a little bit more because we can bring in our own kitchen island, make it cute, add a little bit of our own flair to it. So we really liked that unit, and we got it a little bit cheaper, which was really nice. So those were the two units that we looked at. Having the laundry is huge. We don't have that right now. So we were able to allocate a little bit more in our budget because right now we either send out our laundry or go do it, which at a laundromat, which believe it or not, really does add up throughout the weeks. So having that actually included in our unit is insane and it's great. So we loved that. The thing we noticed with these newer buildings that we really liked and were appealing to us was the closet space. Both of these units had a ton of closets. Like, it's just insane. Like, this place that we're in now, this older pre-war building, it has one closet in our master bedroom and it's all open, so it doesn't have a door. And then the other one is open as well in the office, and it's more of like a doorway type of closet. Like, it's very small. We like to be a little bit more organized, so having a little bit extra closet space was something that we wanted to look for, and we really, really liked that. A few other things we were able to have a little bit extra in our budget is it has a gym, which is great. So we have gym memberships outside of our building right now, obviously, and we would cancel those memberships and just use the one in our building. It also had a huge office space, which is key. We work from home. This is something that maybe a lot of people wouldn't need if you didn't work from home, but it definitely gets a little bit, you can go a little bit crazy if you don't leave your place and you're working constantly from the place that you sleep and eat and hang out in and live in. So it's nice to have a place to go to that you can relax and, you know, do your work outside of your actual apartment. We loved that. And then this also did have a pretty amazing rooftop, which is coveted in New York. So, and I'm forgetting one of the best features of it is it has a doorman and really nice security and a package room and things like that. We ran into some theft issues in this place that we did not love, obviously. So having that is great. Another thing I should mention as well is these units both have central air compared to our place now. We use in window AC units that we purchased. So that definitely is another great feature. So overall, this whole building, these units are a huge, huge, huge step up. A lot more things it can offer us that we really, really liked, and we were not expecting to like that place as much as we did. So that was definitely a huge contender. The next apartment we looked at was located in Borum Hill. The outside of the building was a lot older, and there were a few features that we noticed that we might have the similar issue to what we had in this place, but we really liked the actual apartment. So it is a full two bedroom, so it's not like a one and a half like the last place. One bathroom, a huge, huge kitchen, backyard and a dishwasher, and then the laundry was located in the building, not in the unit. It was just located in the basement of the building. And this is $4,400 a month. So it was more expensive than the last place with less amenities. It is a full two bedroom and you have your private backyard, which we really liked. The backyard patio situation was really, really appealing for many reasons. You guys know we like to hang out with our friends and entertain. If we were to start a family, that would be really fun to be able to have like a kid be able to go outside in like a backyard environment. Like, that's amazing. So there are a lot of things that were appealing to it. A few things we did not like was the huge kitchen, and I know that might seem crazy, but there was just a lot of wasted space for that kitchen. There were so many cabinets. We were told that the tenants before used those last back cabinets as like drawers and closet space, which I didn't love the idea of, but then again, it did give us a lot more storage that we were just needing, which I mentioned we need from this place. But I will tell you right now that that was our least favorite place that we saw, and it was the most expensive, which seemed crazy to me. The last apartment we saw was located in Brooklyn Heights. It is a walk-up brownstone style building, which is beautiful. It is the basement unit of that. It's a full two bedroom, updated appliances, walk-in closet in the master, fireplace in the master bedroom, not a working one, but a beautiful, beautiful fireplace, and a private garden backyard. So, and this price was $4,300 a month. So we absolutely loved this unit. There were a lot of features like the white brick. Ugh, beautiful. The kitchen was very, very big. I loved the open concept of the living room and the dining room, which the fact that you even have a place to put a dining room table in New York is insane. So we loved that. We loved the private backyard. Are you kidding? That's amazing. It was a garden backyard. The other units on the top don't have access to it unless in case of an emergency. So it would be entirely ours. And it is the same price as that first building that we looked at, that we really liked, that updated one. I guess one of the main things and the one thing we noticed, it did have a dishwasher, but it doesn't have laundry, which is fine. We can get over that because we're living with that for 3 years and it's not a huge deal. We did notice the lack of closet space, even though it does have a walk-in closet in the master and a closet in the second bedroom. It doesn't have any hallway closets, which is one of the issues we ran into here. And then of course it's the basement unit, which of course already it ran into issues just in the sense of that we work from home and that I film YouTube videos. So it tends, those basement apartments tend to be a little bit darker. It is connected to the garden backyard, which in my head I kind of thought potential bug issues, which we weren't sure if we wanted to deal with. We already have dealt with them in this building. So we were hesitant on a few things, but this was definitely one that we really loved. Patrick and I really were like, do we want to move into a similar style building like this? But it is a brownstone, which has been a dream of mine for a long time. And you know, I'll start at the basement and work my way up on that brownstone. But we knew that there were going to be some similar issues that we had here, and we weren't 100% sure that we wanted to commit to that one. So those are all the apartments that we looked at. I know it's only three. I could have gone more, but trust me, it's a competitive world out there in apartments for New York. So the longer you wait on one, somebody else is going to come in and rent it right out from under you. So you have to be quick about it. So we saw three, and I'm sure you can tell which one we're leaning towards. Like I said, we haven't decided on one yet. We are probably planning to stay for a couple years and then reevaluating. The thing with New York is that it is in such high demand and neighborhoods change quite frequently, especially in Brooklyn, that who knows how much rent can increase and things like that. Our lifestyle might change. We might have different needs. And yeah, there's no beating around the bush. New York is expensive. It is crazy how much we, and I don't just mean we, but New Yorkers in general, pay for rent for what they're getting. It is crazy. And we love it, and we're still here. We've done it for 5 years, and we are super thankful to be able to apartment hunt in New York and be able to live here. I just want to reiterate that, because it is a humbling experience being able to look at the places and pick between those places, because they're all beautiful, they're all amazing, and to live in any or all of those places and have some of those features is a huge, huge thing. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope I answered your questions. If not, leave them below and I'll talk about them in a vlog, because guess what? We're moving. So there's gonna be moving vlogs coming up, and redecorating vlogs. So much redecorating. I cannot wait. I hope you guys liked it. I'm back. I miss you. Stay tuned for some more videos, and I will see you guys next time. Bye.